Did you know that Ray of Hope Larsa is actually named after Ray of Hope, an ability used by Terra which cures all status ailments? It's also rather useless, except for when it's necessary. Alright, Trustmaster reward. Future Emperor is a materia that boosts MP, one of the least important stats you dedicate a materia slot to. It does, however, have a nifty passive that activates a counter ability, which can restore your team's MP. This could certainly be useful if you face a trial that drains your team's MP. Other than that, you might want to go for something else. His Super Trustmaster reward, Swordbreaker, is a dagger. For a Super Trustmaster reward of its kind, the attack is pretty bad, but the defense is top tier. The spear just exists. It has a passive that can boost your unit's HP and enables a dual wield. I wonder if they released a dual wielding unit that wants high defense. Alright, active abilities. He literally uses items as an ability, which wouldn't be too bad if it wasn't applied to a single unit. Imperial Heir's Authority removes all breaks from your team and grants a 35% general mitigation buff. Aurora Curtain boosts your team's defense by 200%, their light resistance by 80%, and grants a 35% physical mitigation buff. Full Moon Curtain kind of does the opposite. It boosts Spirit, Dark Resistance, and grants a magic mitigation buff. Selfless Spirit is a team-wide buff that grants a decent MP regen, a strong Limit Burst Gauge fill rate boost, and enables 5 active abilities that can further help your team. These are X Potion, a much better heal, All Remedy, which can cure all status ailments and stop, Mega Phoenix Down, a team-wide raise, High Aether, a powerful MP restore, Soleil Fang, a Fire Absolute Mirror of Equity attack that fills Larsa's Limit Burst Gauge by a small amount, and Lightning Fang, which is the same thing but with lightning. He has 3 cooldown abilities. Persuasive Character can convince an enemy to drop their stat boost. Somehow. Bubble Mode activates a HP barrier for your team. Mega Elixir is practically a perfect restore. Alright, passives. He has a counter ability that chucks a high potion at one of their team members. He also has a 10% resistance boost against all elements, a pretty good limit burst fill regen, and some physical evasion. If you'd like to build him, do whatever you want. Send him out naked or armed to the teeth. He's a healer and a supporter, it really depends on the trial. Finally, his limit burst. Special Potion Dance will heal your team, grant an MP regen, sets up a HP barrier, and automatically casts a second one on the following turn. So how good is Larsa? As a supporter, he won't be contributing to damage in any significant fashion. He panders a bit more to the healing side of support, and since most of his abilities are actually items, you don't have to put too much emphasis on his spirit stat, as most of his HP recovery options are actually fixed. Unfortunately, he lacks any status ailment or break resistance buffs, though other than that, he has a pretty compact and useful kit. But still, status ailments and break resistance are pretty significant components, and it's so standard that I think most people will view Larsa rather negatively because of that.